last one quit. I'm not sure why. You can, if you're not quite sure if you're doing a good job or if it looks like you, you can take your picture and look at it. Like right now, it's flipped in the camera view that I'm seeing here. You can use your phone to do that. Or you can actually take it and turn it and look at it in the mirror. So it's going to flip it in a way that will help you see whether it's accurate or not. So now we're going to move between three different tools. We're going to keep working with the charcoal. We're going to use the pencil eraser. And we're going to use the blending stick. So what the blending stick does, you remember from the paint cans that we made, it really helps each surface, each texture, to move from texture to surface. So it allows the face to start to feel like it's all connected. And you can use it to help you find some in-between tones too. There. And I don't know if you saw this here, I just went right through the edge because I know I can come back with an eraser and like really cut that edge to be the shape that I want. Or I can come back with a charcoal and do the same thing. Okay. So, first step is to kind of modulate everywhere you put tone. You're going to start to smooth it out. And then what you're going to do is come back and begin to draw in darker and lighter tones within that value structure. So let's see, I'm just going to do that now. See what I'm doing. I'm just going back in, finding things like the whites of the eyes and areas of highlight and shadow. Okay. I'm trying to create contrast so that I can see, for example, the nose comes out. Front of what's behind. Underneath the nose is always a little bit darker. As well. step back a little bit and look at your drawing with fresh eyes. I'm gonna move over so I'm not in the way. I probably have that. Let me move this closer. Something in a drawing. You can still see where my eye was from the original drawing. It's difficult not to be scared when you're going over something that you've worked on and really labored to find, but because I'm pulling the highlights out of this dark, so much easier to see. Usually darker than the top lip if the light source is coming from above. We all have a habit, you probably remember this from the portraits that we did, we all have a habit of making the lips really like in front, so even though they're in the side, in the middle's here, and this side's a lot longer than this side. We tend to draw them like this. It's okay if your lips kind of merge with the skin around your lips. That's good. That's really the way you want it. If they feel totally outlined, it probably means they're going to feel really separate. They might sort of float off your face, which is not what you want. Fast here, just in the interest of time. I haven't done a whole lot with the ear. Probably comes in a little bit, not quite so big. Those are the sort of alterations you can make as you go. Remember, it's all about editing. Looking again, looking more precisely, seeing what's really there instead of what you think is there. Okay. And again, you want to connect your neck to your head. So if this all has some tone, you know, your neck should probably have a little bit of tone too. Or if you're neck is, your face is really in shadow and really dark. Just go back and forth, refining, pulling out details. But remember, you're always beginning with a large structure first, and the details second. Spray fixative, which I didn't send home with you, then you could always use hairspray if you have some to fix your drawing, since we're using this fine charcoal. Structure, add value, lights and darks.